So I'm at the airport to pick up my babies. God, I can't wait to see them. I've waited. God! You all have been following my videos, yeah? Baby now is 10 weeks old. And I was here before baby was born. I was here about a month before baby was born. So I've been away from them for so long. I've never been away from my children. So let's pause for a bit and go back to Nigeria. So I ordered foodstuffs from vendors. I ordered fish, gari, ogbono egusi, all the kind of leaves you can think of that are dried up, so many things, so that when these children come here, they will not start fighting to eat Oyibo food, so they can eat the food that they know of for the meantime, the time being that we are here together. I made them weigh all of the bags. Like, I don't want them having issues at the airport. We had to weigh so that we don't exceed the stipulated kg. I had to borrow the scale from the gas man that sold gas in the neighborhood, and then I used the small scale for Angel's baking. We weighed all the items before putting them into the bag. We got noodles and every other thing you can think of. I don't want to even bore you with the details, yeah? God bless that my adopted daughter Yolanda. Before she went to school, she helped so much. God will bless her for me. The kids made their hair, they're looking all good. Hey, because making hair, yeah, it's equivalent to about 60 to 70,000 naira. God forbid, but they had to make their hair before coming here, before the thing goes scatter. Hey, they go down sabi make them by themselves, or they go down come back. All right, so the kids are here. I said these kids traveled by themselves and people still do not believe. You never know what's possible until you are in that situation. So I made an arrangement with the airline and the air hostess. They helped in watching over the kids while they were in the plane and whilst they were at the airport until they met with me. Oh, see them excited.
Excited to see mom and baby.
Yes,
can't wait. We are waiting for her now, so she's yet to show up, so when she comes then we all go home together. I'm so excited.
So I'm seated at a spot where I would see them. I would sight them when they come in. God has been so faithful, channeling the right sources, the right people in the right places for me. Every step along the way, it's been favor, favor, favor. This is a testimony. I wanted to come with the baby, but you know, I had to travel about 3 hours from where I am at, from my city. So I had to pump a lot of milk for my friend to look after her for me while I I'm looking around. I'm not looking at the camera because I don't want to miss them. If they come in now, I'm gonna stop this video and just capture. Okay, so I have to pump a lot of milk because it's 3 hours going and 3 hours coming. I couldn't even sleep last night. I was cooking rice and stew, something they can easily rustle up. I think I see them. Oh my God. At this point, my phone fell. I froze. I was so excited, I even stopped recording. So I gave my son the camera to video the rest of the reactions. Hours away from my baby, she was crying when I got home. I quickly went upstairs and told my friend not to bring her down until I asked her to. So now I'm about to take the baby to see our siblings. Dave's reaction was heavenly.
Fragile.
Toby. Toby.
Yeah, go down with you. Oh, you did the hey guy.
Ah, you know me. You know me.
The driver is.
Yes. Hi. Okay.
Oh, her face is very small.
You say?
That is so small.
Yes. Yes. What do you have to say? My sweet rats. My sweet rats. Very good for you, dragons.
Oh, what did you ask for
from them?
What did you ask
for? My sister. Oh. Don't worry. When I open, when we settle the up one, I'll call you. I'll reserve the album for you.
We finally made it home.
Yeah.
Oh my god. She's wondering, what is this? Look at the view. It's so amazing. Exactly. Thank God for a safe trip.
My baby's at home. Where is Dave?
No mind.
Well, these are my three daughters. Look at this one.
Bubu, say hi.
Hi. So we did not sleep last night or on time. I think the kids went to sleep about 1 a.m. We couldn't have enough of each other. We were catching up until 1 a.m. And when they went to sleep, I did not sleep. I had to come up. This is about 3 a.m. I was sneaking up on them to see if they are really in the room or if they've disappeared. Hey, God, these children traveled thousands of miles to come see me and baby, and they are, yeah, live and direct. Thank you, Jesus. And if you've watched up until now and you've not hit that subscribe button yet, I'm wondering, are we fighting? Can you kindly like this video, share, show some love, show some excitement, you know, subscribe already. So yeah, so I had to also creep in on my son to see if he's also there. Or was it only my daughters that came without him? And he's there soundly sleeping. So stay tuned as we bring you more juicy stuff on the Choice Family TV.